In this video, we're gonna take a look at exactly how I use SEMrush to find KGR terms. Now, when I first started testing the keyword golden ratio, I used SEMrush almost exclusively to try and figure out what keywords to go for. And it took me several months to figure out like the right filters to use. And by the way, that's what I'm gonna kind of show you in this. There are four or five filters that you can set up and tweak to really narrow it down. So I'm gonna show you which filters I use and when to use them. And the thing is, you can narrow down tens of thousands of keywords to a few dozen keywords that you can check with pretty good confidence that those are the kind of keywords that will be keyword golden ratio terms. Now, I use SEMrush when I was testing the KGR. And in one of the later videos, I'm gonna tell you about a case study where I published like 200 posts on one site and grew the revenue from about $100 per month to about $14,800 within 12 months just by publishing keyword golden ratio terms. No link. All right, so that's what we're looking at today. Now be sure, if you haven't watched the other videos, be sure to check out some of the other videos in this playlist. In fact, what you'll need to do after you get the list of keywords from SEMrush, you'll need to use the worksheet for the KGRs. And that is, I showed you how to use that in the first video of this playlist. So be sure to check it out if you haven't. And let's go ahead and get to the demo right now. We're looking at SEMrush right now. And this is the paid version. This is the full version here. And you can get a trial, I think, for either 7 or 14 days, depending on what they're offering. But the affiliate link is below. So if you use it, thank you. I get a small commission if you actually become a paid customer. But even if you only use this for 7 days, you can get a ton of value. So this is like the main dashboard. And of course, the focus of this video is finding keyword golden ratio terms using SEMrush. So there are many different things you can do with SEMrush, but we're just gonna look at the organic keyword section because that is most relevant for the keyword golden ratio. So while you can do a lot of stuff, we're just gonna focus on the organic keywords. Now, as you know, probably, when I tear down sites, when we look at other sites here, basically I'm trying not to out anyone else's site. So we're gonna look at a very big site that's owned by a corporation. We're gonna look at the Wirecutter. So this will still give us an interesting set of data, but we're probably not going to find specific KGR terms. But what I'm going to tell you are strategies so that you can use like some smart filters to get to the KGR terms for whatever site that you're looking for. So there's a couple things we're going to take a look at. We're just going to look at the Wirecutter right off the bat. So when you're in the dashboard, you put in like whatever website you're looking for. I advise you to just put in like the domain name .com.org. Don't put in like http://. Don't put in the full like URL like that. Just look at the overall domain. That'll give you the best information. As you can see, there's a lot of data on here. So I'll just quickly go over a couple things because it's useful. So organic search, that's the estimated monthly traffic based on organic search traffic. So when you hover over any of these sections, it'll tell you what it is. No paid traffic is being noted here. The number of backlinks is listed. So 536,000 from 6,500 referring domains. And by the way, I think the backlink numbers on SEMrush are not complete. I think Ahrefs has more data. And as far as displayed advertising, that's not super relevant here. And I basically just look at organic search and maybe I'll peruse just quickly the backlinks. So that's what we're seeing here. The next section here shows us like the geography of where the organic traffic is coming from. As you can see, 60% is from the US and another 8.5% is from mobile US and so on. So that's interesting to note. The other part is they show you the amount of paid traffic and the organic traffic over time. And you can see in like January, February of 2018, like there's huge growth over here at the wire cutter. So that's interesting. And it's just been continuous growth, like, since the, it looks like. The part we care about is the organic keywords, which we'll take a look at a sec in a second here. But 1.5 million keywords is what the wire cutter is ranking for. And this is, you know, ranked in the order of like how much volume it brings in, potentially the amount of traffic for the wire cutter. Next, the organic position distribution is interesting. So there are 32,000 of those keywords are in the top three, 114,000 are in positions 4 through 10, and so on. So this is 1.5 million keywords ranked in the top 100. All right. So really the ones that are most important are the ones that are ranked on the first page in the top 10. If you're ranked like 11 or beyond, you're getting a fraction of the traffic. Now the wire cutter, because it's so reputable, because it's such a big company, maybe they get a little bit more traffic, but essentially you're mainly getting traffic, or a website is getting traffic, if they're ranking in the top 10 in Google, typically. Another section to point out is the main organic competitors. So it tells you sort of the relative competition level, and that is like common keywords and just in general, the number of search engine keywords that they're ranking for. So this means that PCMag.com has 79,000 keywords in common with the wire cutter. Top 10 reviews has 41,000 keywords that are in common with the wire cutter. So that's what that means in the competitive positioning map. It sort of gives you a bubble graph, so you kind of see like where people are relative to each other. So very interesting, very interesting. And that also means that PCMag has 3.2 million keywords ranking in the top 100. That is why, you know, they're listed up here. This graph shows the organic search traffic. I should have pointed this out, and the number of organic keywords. So it's a very interesting graph, and you know, you can get a decent amount of data relative to like where that site is compared to other sites. So you get an idea of how many keywords they're ranking for and how much traffic that brings in. So if we look here, we see that Tech Radar is ranking for like about 3 million keywords, and they're getting like 15 million in the organic traffic, or 14 million. And if you hover over it, it'll tell you that right there in the graph. All right, so what we're gonna do, we'll keep looking down. So branded search traffic, interesting to note. Follow and no follow links. So again, I don't really look at SEMrush for the backlinks. If it's the only tool you have, then you know it can give you some good information. But if you look at Ahrefs, you'll see that, you know, Ahrefs has a lot more data on the backlinks. Okay, so now we're going to get over to the more interesting part. So you could click on View Full Report, and then that'll take you over to the keyword, organic keyword section, and it'll tell you all these keywords that the wire cutter is ranking for and the percentage of traffic, the estimated percentage of traffic that each one of those keywords is bringing in for the wire cutter. So air purifier is apparently the number one term right now, right? So this varies, and it's a huge search term. So 135,000 searches per month, and it's a very, you know, difficult keyword just in general, and they're ranking number one in Google for that. So that's kind of crazy. And so as we look at this, we see that 1.5 million keywords is a lot to sort through. That is not helpful. And one of the most common questions I get is, how can you like find KGR terms a little bit easier? What's a good starting? So this is how we're gonna do it. I did a little search earlier for best lawnmower as the keyword that we're going to look at here. So you could just type in, you know, whatever you want to filter on. And this is, by the way, this is the best way to do it. So, you know, you end up on this screen here, and you could filter by a keyword. So that's how you could sort of narrow it down. If you're looking for buyer's keywords, which many of us are looking for buyer's keywords, you would want to put in the word like best, right? Best is usually a good format for these kind of keywords. So put in best, you'll want to include something with best that's in the keyword, and we want it to contain that. Next, like I said, I just wanted to narrow it down to lawnmower, and there's a couple public case studies on lawnmowers, and here's the deal. I don't think, I could be totally wrong, but not that many people are buying lawnmowers online. Some people are, but it turns out they're heavy, right? They're heavy pieces of machinery. So most people are probably not buying lawnmowers online. And, you know, they're going down to the hardware store that's local. They're going to Home Depot, Lowe's, whatever, buying it from Ace Hardware, right? So that's another reason I picked this one, public case study. So, and we're also looking at the wire cutter. So we're looking at this and we see we've narrowed down from the 1.5 million keywords here to 1,800, and that's a lot easier to deal with. So at this point, you could potentially just hit export, go ahead and pull your CSV or however you want to take your data, and then you can sort it a little more effectively in a spreadsheet format. Most people are more comfortable working with a spreedsheet, and of course, at that point, you could save some data, run some more interesting filters, stuff like that. I would say 1,800 is still a lot to sort through. So what are some other filters that I run? And this is sort of like advanced stuff. So it's not complicated, but typically it's not the most obvious thing that people are gonna like try and do. So here's what I would do. First, I'm gonna say, let's say, I want to find keywords for the keyword golden ratio. So I want the search volume to be less than, let's say 250. Stick to the formula and then I'll click apply. So remember we were at 1800. So let's see what we end up at here. All right. So we got rid of quite a few of them, like 45% of them or so. So now we're at 1,000. That's still a lot. So what other filters could I add? So I'm going to add another filter. I'm going to say, how about stuff where the wire cutter is ranking in the top 20. So that is indicating, maybe the wire cutter isn't trying to rank for it necessarily, and they're in the top 20. All right, so now we're down to 800. So we got rid of another 20% from where we were at. So now we're getting somewhere. So let's add another filter and try and find like longer phrases. So these are typically, a KGR term is typically a longer phrase. So we'll say number of words is greater than 4. And I believe this is actually a equal to or greater than situation. So hopefully I didn't test this beforehand. So hopefully this is going to work out. So we're at 271. Now we're talking. So this is, you're only looking through a few hundred of these terms at this point. So we went from 1.5 million for all the keywords that the wire cutter is ranking for to, narrowing it down to your niche, applying some smart filtering techniques so that you can narrow it down even more. And then you're able to, really get a handle on some of these keywords that may be really good for KGR terms. And if you recall some of the other videos in this series, by the way, if you haven't watched all the playlists or if you haven't watched all the videos in this playlist, then you should definitely check it out. I talked to several people who have used the keyword golden ratio and got like tons of success, right? So here is one little like ninja hack that you may not think of. So we're looking at keywords less than with a volume of less than 250, because that'll fit in the keyword golden ratio. So that's great. We're narrowing it down quite a bit here. But what if instead we're looking at very low volume keywords? So instead of this 250, let's just sort this the other direction. So perhaps we'll get a picture of, easier to rank for keywords. So now we're looking at keywords with a search volume of 10, and it's in ascending order here. So basically what we're seeing here is probably, most likely, keywords that are much easier to rank for because they have a low volume. Now, here's the deal, right? So we have 270 of them, or 167 in this list, which I'm not sure why that changed just now, but regardless, we have 167. My guess is there's probably like 20 or 40 KGR terms in this list, right? So not every one of these is going to be great. In fact, a lot of them are probably not going to be bad or not going to be great. They're going to be redundant. Here's one, best rated lawnmowers 2014, right? It's 2018 when I'm recording this right now. Probably not going to want to do that one. But best push lawnmower under 200, hey, that works. That's actually a pretty good one to go after. So using these techniques, you're going to find that it's much easier to find KGR terms. Now, let me go back and show you another little ninja hack, right? So we have, we identified the site we wanted to check out doing keyword research, right? So the wire cutter has, some keywords that we've identified that could be viable to go after. So after we do the, analysis here, I'm going to export it to a CSV, use Google Sheets to do further analysis. I'm going to go back to the general wire cutter dashboard view here and the main organic competitors. We're going to look at the full report here. What we're going to see is all the competitors that the wire cutter has. And what you can do then is cherry pick other sites to do the exact same analysis. So you would do what I just mentioned for PC Magazine, for top 10 reviews, for best products, Tech Radar, and so on, however many you want to do. Then you run the same filters on their organic keywords. You export those. You combine all those keywords into one spreadsheet. Then you have a sort of aggregated list of the competitors for the keywords that you're looking for. And they're generally sorted in a, fashion where, or they're filtered in a fashion where you've cut a lot of the fat out and you're just looking at probably the keywords that are pretty close to KGR terms. And, just for fun, let's say 5 words or more. Let's see what happens then. And now we're talking 90 keywords. So much more manageable to run the data. At this point, you could, take this exported file potentially, right? You could send it to a VA to check the KGR terms for you. One of the biggest complaints I get about the keyword golden ratio is it's slow, it's boring to do, and it's very manual. So if you don't want to do it, you can hire someone else to do it. Now, it's not really that bad once you get going. To be honest with you, what I find is once I get like one or two terms that look pretty good, I'll find 5 or 6 related terms when you start looking in the the Google Auto Suggest and the Google related searches. Those are just filled with keywords that maybe you didn't think of. Those are sometimes zero search volume. And if it's showing up as an auto suggest and zero search volume, I'll typically go for it no matter what the all-in title is. Now, your mileage may vary on that, but for me, I'm thinking, hey, most people are not going to go for a zero all-in title, but I will. So if you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. And don't forget, check out the rest of the videos in the playlist. Should be very helpful for you if you're trying to apply the KGR.